A 30 moment.
Power 93, it's 422. We're Tim and Tom, and yes, it feels good. It feels good to have the Lord inside of me.
We're practicing here because my parents are coming to town this afternoon, and we've got a six-point plan to turn the Power Pig into a gospel radio station.
Power 93 is WFLZ, Tampa Bay's Almighty FM.
Hallelujah, brethren. Power 93, you can feel the power. We are brethren, Tim and Tom, and that was Amy Grant, a contemporary Christian singer, and she does just a wonderful job, Tom.
Praise Jesus, a wonderful job. It's time now for a church announcement here. The ladies group at Bedside Baptist will be meeting at Norma Jean Moskal's house this Sunday night after church for a bake sale. We just like to announce that here.
They're doing a little fundraiser over there at Bedside, and we pray for them. We want you to know that you are in our prayers, so you will be able to raise money for the work of the Lord that you're doing there.
Praise God. And now we go back to more religious music right here on Power 93.
The only station with local church bulletins, 24 hours a day, every day. Power 93. Power 93.
30 thoughts.
NYQ in Miami, I think, would have been considered the first FM Top 40. And so that progression started to take off with FMs doing Top 40 across the country.
Buzz had chutzpah. He went ahead and did what he thought he wanted to do. Pretty much whether anybody else agreed with him or not.
You had mono over here, and all of a sudden you're hearing instruments you've never heard before. And it's like, wow, man, stereo, listen to that.
FM stood for fine music, maybe even freaky music, but never Top 40. The conventional wisdom was it just wouldn't work. Buzz Bennett and Al Casey didn't buy it, though. On March 1, 1971, they launched the nation's first FM Top 40, WMYQ Miami.
WMYQ and Al Casey at 943. Get up a good head of steam for Nana Hey Hey. Can you dig it? WMYQ, let's get it on now. Come on, it's Friday. Pick out the jam. Let's get ready for the weekend. Wow, Roby Young, 337.
Oh, yeah, baby, it's 9 o'clock, fun-loving WMYQ Miami, Burn City, Burn! This is J. Michael Stone out, rock and roll your face right up! Yeah, I like that noise, I tell you that! I can't stand it!
A year later, former KHJ PD Ron Jacobs, fresh on the heels of creating a new syndicated show called American Top 40, was lured to San Diego by Brown Broadcasting's KGB. Jacobs hit town, scoped things out, commissioned a research project, rare for the time, and then, on Easter weekend 1972, presented his audio thesis on the state of Top 40 radio and what KGB planned to do about it.
We're reshaping the sound of KGB, and based on what you've told us, our new policy better be a very simple one. Play good rock and roll music and tell the truth. No more too hip or too hype labels for this radio station. We're putting all our energy into the way we sound. And we'll keep doing it till we get it right by you. Early on, in the dawn of the rock revolution, the Beatles said, "Can't buy me love." So true in 72. KGB, the recycled KGB, doesn't expect you to like us because we give you a free electric knife, or a free t-shirt, or a free album, or a free trip to Bangladesh. Everything you've told us says that kind of radio is a dead giveaway. Everybody involved in KGB's sound will be here tomorrow, getting it together and closed-circuit testing. Check us out. Let us know if you can dig it. It's our turn to do the listening, and we know it. Today, we're recycling this announcement. Tomorrow, we're recycling the radio station. And the radio station is 1360 KGB, San Diego.
And so Jacob's situation at KGB sort of became this national industry phenomenon of Ron Jacobs using Top 40 techniques from one of the greatest top 40 formats of all time, Boss Radio.
Mike Harrison.
In a progressive album rock environment.
As Jacobs was recycling KGB, the Fairchild Aircraft Company bought KLIF Dallas from Gordon McClendon for $10 million. At the time, the most money ever paid for a radio station. During last-minute negotiations, McClendon offered to throw his FM station into the deal.
And there was a hush-hush silence of a few minutes.
Ken Dow.
And they leaned over and whispered in each other's ears. And finally, they look up and say, "No, I don't think so, but how much money do you want for it?" And Gordon said, "Well, I don't know." And he looked at me, and I said, "I don't know." And he said, "How about $150,000? They said, "No, thank you. We're going to take the cash cow. We don't want the FM radio station, so we'll just go with KLI for $10 million, and you guys can keep that."
Money!
There is no bubblegum on K-News. We don't program for teenagers. For instance, we don't play the Jackson 5, Partridge Family, David Cassidy, any of the music which appeals exclusively to teeny boppers. What we do is embellish our unique format with the particularly unique McClendon promotional touch. Just listen to some of the promotions we've run on KNUS, all in the last 10 months. KNUS, creator of the Great Ripoff, Keep On Truckin', Christmas Wish, The World's Greatest Contest, and others too numerous to mention. Now, brings you our first major blow-off of 1973. All weekend, instant rip-offs, as close as your telephone, just call in to win. KNUS will be giving away the album of your choice. Or choose one of those hard-to-get truckin' tops. Plus, at any minute, we just might blow off some instant cash.
$100 bills.
$20 bills.
$50 bills.
As close as your phone, you can try to win up to 10,000 times.
KNUS celebrates the peace by giving away the war. Beginning 24 hours ahead of the scheduled ceasefire.
K-News wasn't the first FM Top 40, but it was the first to score major ratings. Meanwhile, in Los Angeles, an AM programmer named Bob Wilson, a contrarian who opted to play FM progressive music on K-Day AM, came up with an idea for a new trade magazine.
He's telling me he was planning to start a tip sheet to compete with Billboard for the attention of radio. This tip sheet he was going to call Radio and Records, and it was going to be launched within a few weeks.
When Bob decided he wanted to do this, he called a few people around the country, and I was at Quixi at the time.
John Leader.
And he outlined his ideas for airplay statistics and integrity and not being beholden to anybody else, and it just sounded like a great idea, and I fully supported it, so I became one of his first reporters.
October 5th, 1973, Radio and Records debuted. By the way, here's something you probably don't know. When Wilson started R&R, he also had a syndication partnership with Wolfman Jack.
You know, the soul can rise from the earth like into the sky, like a bird aware of its freedom, not feeling the barriers of man, but the beauty of love, which is eternal.
Right on, Wolfman.
Right on. Oh, we rocking and rolling tonight, baby. You know what I mean. Get down.
I know, New York, you ain't gonna believe this, but Alice Cooper just walked in here, man.
Ow.
Yes, he did, and he brought me the biggest cake I have ever seen in my entire life. This cake must be about 5 feet wide.
Ursula Andress is baked into the middle of it.
The who?
Ursula Andress.
Oh, no. Yeah, I thought you told you put your bull constrictor in the middle, man.
No, we had her on the outside.
Did you bring your boa constrictor with you?
No, I couldn't do that to you.
Have you seen Agnes? I bought one, too, you know.
You got one?
Yeah, well, I got one 40 feet long, and it's at least 7 inches thick, man.
You want a mate?
Huh? I was thinking about it. Is yours a female or male?
I don't know. I can't figure it out.
Well, I called mine Agnes. I haven't really decided whether it's a female or male.
Well, you know, these days, you never can tell.
Alice, you're looking good. Here, blow the whistle for me, will you, please? Alice, go blow the whistle. All right, play his record. Get down. He just brought me some payola, you know, that big cake and everything. And we're going to party later on. Get down with Alice, baby. New York City. Take me home.
It was 30 years and 1,500 issues ago, and how radio looked at itself was about to change.
Hey, it's John Hollywood Hamilton. And you know, by the 70s, rock and roll was called rock, and albums had become like the delivery system of choice. Unless, of course, you were hooked on one of them big fat-ass 8-tracks. During the 70s, we met groupies, singer-songwriters, supergroups, power chords, urban cowboys, funk, and of course, let's not forget, punk. And while kids at 1,000 Ridgemont High Schools all over the country overdosed on 1,000,000 Led Zeppelin LPs, disco danced its way up the charts, and FM stereo started to become the dominant new voice of change. During the 70s, MOR became Pop Adult. Progressive Underground became AOR, and the editors of R&R renamed Top 40 Contemporary Hit Radio. Now, here's an audio snapshot of the 70s.
30 Record Flashback. Time keeps on slipping, slipping, slipping.
I shot the sheriff, and you wear it well.
Very superstitious.
We witch and Boston.
She's buying a stairway.
Whatever gets you through the night. It's alright. It's alright.
I like it.
Working on a night move.
George, he knows all the chords.